Hello everyone, we have been building our tower defense game step by step with a new mechanic for every episode. And in this video, we will see what is the last piece of the puzzle to be able to make a full tower defense game. And that is building the main menu with a level picker and see how we can handle the scenes or loading and unloading of different scenes and sub-scenes from script to be able to change level when the player has successfully completed the level. So let's get to it. As usual, you can get the full code to follow along with this video in the GitHub repository linked in the description below. You can download the 9th folder and add it to your project, or download all of them and start from a blank project if you want. And if you need to, you can have a look at the previous video to understand how we have built things up until now. The folder structure remains the same. We don't have any authoring or ECS components, but we have a mono behavior, which will be our level manager, which is a singleton mono behavior, as we've seen in the previous episode. We have a few prefabs for our different entities for the actual game scene. We also have the UXML document, so it's a UI Toolkit document to handle the UI part of the project. We have several scenes. So I split the scenes into the main scene, so the main menu scene, that's where you start playing. Then I have an environment sub-scene, which will be the environment, general environment of our game. So here it's just the green plane that is displayed here. And then I have a game scene that will make use of both the levels and load the appropriate level based on what the user has picked. And if he has won the level, to move to the next level. So you can open the menu level scene and look at the environment sub scene. So like I said, it's just the simple plane here. We have the UI document, which contains the UXML document with the 4 buttons, the 2 of the level picker and the 2 buttons for going back to the menu and retry. It will be displayed based on the situation. And we have a level manager with a level manager script. So this one will take in the game scene, which we will see in a few minutes, the menu scene, which we are currently in, the sub scene, which when I click on it, it's my environment sub scene in the main level, main menu, and the UI document to actually handle the UI part of the screen. I also have a link to the 2 sub scenes. And lastly, I have my subscene itself with the subscene component, which we have not seen yet. But the subscene mono behavior allows you to control the loading of the subscene from the inspector with the auto load scene. So here, if it's checked and I start playing the game, the scene will be loaded. We have the environment subscene that has been loaded. And if I actually go to the component again and check the auto load scene, you can see that it disappeared. And if I enter play mode, it has also not been loaded. So that's the first way we can handle scene loading. And actually that's what I'm using in the game scene. So if I look at the game scene, I just have the main camera light and the environment subscene is auto-loaded. So when I load the game scene, I will also load the environment subscene. Let's go back to the main menu levels and look at the level manager. If I take a look at the script, I can see that, okay, I have a basic singleton implementation here, where I can get the instance from the static instance field, and that will be populated as part of the awake method. I have all the declaration I need to have for me to be able to set things in the inspector. And I also keep track of the current level index, so the current level index that is loaded, and the entity corresponding to the current level. We'll see just in a minute why I need to keep track of that. when I start, I say that I don't want, when the scene, new scene is loaded or whatever, I don't want to destroy this level manager. And I also don't want to destroy the UI because I'm using it as part of the in-game UI. You could also use a different UI setup or a different scene even for each of your UI based on your preferences. Here I just did that for simplicity. I initialize the current level at -1, meaning that it's not no level is loaded, and same thing for the current level entity, which I set to entity.null, because entity is a struct, so we can't set it to the null value. So in fact, there is a entity.null value that gives it an index that is recognized as a null entity. Then I have a few private fields to get the UI elements from my UI document, so the UXML, so the level picker, which is taken from the name level picker, and the game over screen, which is the game over tag here. As part of the start method, I'm also setting up the level picker, so I just get the level picker item and iterate over all the buttons in the list to assign them a level ID, which is just the index of the button in the hierarchy of the UI document, and that will match the level index of the index I've put in this level scenes list. And when I click on the button, I use the start game at level, giving it as parameter the level index that I'm setting, so 0 for the first button and so on. For the game over screen, I'm also taking it from the UI element and setting it to visible false so that I can play the game actually, and I will enable it to visible true when the game is lost. And same thing, same setup for the retry and the back button. So the back button will load the main menu. So we're going back to the main menu, so the level picker. And for the next level, I'm actually loading the level based on the current level index. And we can have a look at the first method actually. So loading the game, starting the game at a given level. So if I click on it, I can see that the first thing I do is load the game scene. So if I look at this one, loading the game scene will actually use the scene manager. So that's all usual game object and mono behavior. I have the scene manager and I'm loading the scene based on its name, loading it as a single scene, so meaning that all other scenes will be unloaded. But that does not apply to subscenes. So I also need to actually unload the subscene. And to unload a subscene, I need to use the scene system, not the scene manager. And by calling the unload scene, giving it the default world, the scene GUID, which I take from the scene here. So the subscene that I've passed in as scene, so the one I've set from the inspector. And as a parameter, I'm also saying that as part of this unloading, I want to destroy all the meta entities. So it's the actual entities that represent the scene and that have a few components like the scene sections and so on. We won't cover that in this video, but basically I'm cleaning up both the scene and all the entities related to the scene. Next, I want to load the level at the given level number, so it's the method that is just below. So I will hide the level picker, so from the UI. I will set again the game over screen as false in case I'm loading the next level as part of the game loop, a bit of logging, and if the current level is not null, so it's not the null entity. I'm actually unloading the current level, so I'm using the same kind of method than above, using the scene system, unloading scene, passing in the default world. This time I'm giving it the current level, and the current level, as a reminder, is in fact the entity itself, representing the level. So it's a bit different because here I was, in the previous example, I was using the scene GUID, and here I'm using an actual entity. And same thing, and also using the different parameters to unload all related metadata entities. And then if I'm at the last level, I'm loading the main scene again. And if I'm not at the last level, I'm actually loading the level. So the new level index will be this level index that I'm passing in as parameter. And this time I'm using again the scene system, because what I'm loading is not a scene, but a sub scene. And I'm loading the sub scene with the default world and the actual entity scene reference, this time coming from the level scenes. So here I'm using a list of entity scene reference that is populated from the inspector. And finally, the last method we didn't see is the load main menu, which is just to unload the current level again, because I'm going back from the current level to a menu level if the current level is not null. And I'm setting the current level as null. And actually here I forgot to also set it to the entity null. And I'm loading this time the scene, so the main menu scene, as a single scene loading, and setting the game over screen as not visible if I was in a case of lost game. So if we try it, we can enter play mode and pick either level 1 or 2, and I can press 1, and there is an exception, because the game scene is not part of the build settings, so I need to add it. So let's do that quickly. Go to File, Build Settings. And here I'm just having the default sample scene of a project. And what I actually need is to have the game scene to be able to load it. And I also actually need the menu level, which will be my first scene. So that I can load it back when I'm exiting the game. So let's see if it's working now. I can enter play mode, load the level 1 for instance, and I'm logging the fact that I'm loading level index 0. My little slimes are coming over, and I've lost the game because I can't place anywhere. It's just a simple example. Here I can either retry. So if I retry, all the entities are destroyed, I'm loading again the scene level 0 and starting over. Or I can go back to the main menu. I can actually pick the number 2. And here I just reversed the scene and changed the enemies to show that it's another level. And same thing, I am losing at some point. So now you have all the knowledge you need to be able to build a complete tower defense game. And if you want to challenge yourself, you can actually try to reuse some of the elements we have used here, or we have implemented here, to be able to build something that is more game-like and not just separate core features, let's say. And if you want to support me, you can support me on Ko-fi, and if you support me on Ko-fi, you will also have access to a 10th folder. So this folder where I've put every mechanics and added a few additional system, and you will have something that looks like this, which is a full game with a main menu scene, with a demonstration of the core mechanics. a level picker, so I can pick the level 1, for instance, and when I'm in level 1, I can place a tower, which costs me 3 coins. I can change the tower I want to place, which costs me more points. And once the enemies arrive, I will shoot them and kill them, earning more coin. I lose health if the enemies reach the end, and I'm able to go back to the main menu or go to the next level. And on the next level, I have a bit more coins, so I can place more towers, wait for enemies to arrive, kill them, and keep going. And here I have one, so I go back to the main menu. If you're interested to have this project, you can go to my copy page and you will get the last folder, which will show you how to put everything together, add a few systems to handle the economics side of the game, but all the core mechanics, all the tools you need to actually make all of this system and the mono behaviors and everything have already been shared as part of the tutorial series. So you can challenge yourself to do something like that. And if you want to get the solution, you can grab it from my Ko-fi page if you want to support me. Thank you again for watching. If you like, don't forget to like and share the video. If you want to support me but you don't want to have any additional cost to you, you can use the affiliate link in the description below. There are plenty of awesome assets in the asset store, plenty of sales all the time. Don't forget about the publisher of the week, and also check out the list of the dots asset I could find on the asset store. Some of them are pretty good to work around some of the weaknesses of ECS, such as animation, for instance. So go take a look, and I will see you in the next video.